The asset browser is the single most important thing that you need to work faster on your Blender projects. I'll show you how to set up the asset browser, how to add assets to it, how to make catalogs and subcatalogs, and some quick tips to use the asset browser better. Let's get started. To make an asset browser, we have to have some assets. These are my assets. Actually, I downloaded them from various asset libraries. The first thing we are going to do is making our asset library. Go to Edit, Preferences, File Path. So this is where our created asset libraries will appear. Click on this plus button. What we are going to do is create a folder where we'll save all of our assets. I'll name it Assets. Open the folder, click on Add Asset Library. Here you can see new asset library created. Don't worry about the other one. It's from an add-on I use. Save Preferences or Auto Save Preferences. Now go to this top left corner, and when your cursor turns into crosshair, click and drag like so. Now select Asset Browser from this menu. On default you have these hair assets, but that's not what we want. Click on All. This would show you all the asset libraries you have. Select this current file option, because we have all of these assets in our current file. Now we can add these to our asset browser. Select All, go to the outliner, right click and select Mark as Asset. Now you can see everything over here. In some of these thumbnails, you can see the material, but don't worry, they are there. So, a little challenge for you. I noticed that I am going to say the word assets too much in this video. Can you keep count and tell me at the end of this video? These are uncategorized for now. So, let me add a catalog by pressing this plus button. I'll name it Interior Models. Select all and move them into our Interior Models catalog that we just made. Press this button to save and save your blend file also. Now let's see if this is working. Open a new Blender project. Go to Asset Browser, but you can see our assets anywhere. If we change from current file to assets, still we don't see anything. The reason we don't see our assets is, we haven't saved our blend files in our asset folder that we made earlier. So go to the previous blend file where we have all of our assets. Go to File, Save As, open asset folder we made earlier, and save this blend file. Now you can see them in the asset folder. For some reason, the catalog we made earlier is not here anymore. But don't worry about it. Let's go to our new Blender project. Select Asset from the menu. Now we can see all the assets that we added earlier. Let's add these to our new scene now. Go back to the other blend file where we have all of our assets. I'll change this from asset to current file. It doesn't matter though, since we have saved this in our asset library. Next, I'm going to categorize them into different catalogs. Click on this button and add few catalogs and name them appropriately. Then select these assets and move them into relevant categories. Save the catalogs over here. If you want, you can adjust the display size of these thumbnails, like so. In case you want to remove one of these assets, select the asset, right-click on it in the outliner and select Clear Asset. Now in the asset browser, you can't find it anywhere. I'll make that table an asset again and save your blend file also. By the way, I wanted to thank all of you for showing your love for this channel. I just reached 300 subscribers, so that's a great thing for the channel, so thank you. Now go back to our new Blender project. Let's refresh the assets library and see. Here we can see the catalogs that we just made. Let me close this and open a new project. Let's open the asset browser again and see. Go to the assets folder. Now you can see the catalogs that we made. Go back to the other blend file where we have all of our assets, because we have much more to do. The next thing we'll do is make a subcatalog. Under catalog, press this plus button to make another catalog. Let's name it Small Plants. Let me clear this asset and mark it an asset again. It's uncategorized now. Select it, drag and move it to the Small Plant subcatalog. Now it's in the subcatalog. And if you hide the Small Plant catalog, you will still see it in the main catalog. Now I want to show you something more interesting. Look at this small plant. It's rotated in the viewport, although it looks straight in the asset browser. Why is that? Let me first clear this asset. Press N to see its transformations. So you can see this rotation. It is not applied yet. Let's apply the rotation and make it an asset again. Now it is rotated in the asset browser. So if something is rotated in the asset browser and you add it to the scene, then it would be rotated in your scene also. Now I'll make this straight and mark as an asset again. The thing you should remember is to apply the transformations before you marking them as assets. Not only the rotation, you have to apply the scale also, if you haven't already. The final thing I want to show you is how these objects snap to the surfaces perfectly. It's so great, now you don't have to worry about overlapping between objects. So that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed my content. If you did, hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this and want to learn about interior modeling in Blender, subscribe me. Here's me showing you how to make an interior scene in Blender.